Hi guys. So Stephen and I are heading into Trader Joe's right now. Oh, it looks like there's like a line to get in. So we're gonna have to wait online because we need to get some food. And this is the only reason we can leave our house. So we're gonna go and I'll show you guys like a little Trader Joe's haul when we get home. Because I'm not gonna vlog and stuff in the store. There's like a lot of people obviously here waiting online. So this is what life is like now. All right, we just left Trader Joe's. We have our bags in the back now. Now we're on our way to a different food store because my mom doesn't like Trader Joe's. She likes another food store. And I have been doing the grocery shopping for my parents because both of my parents are like well into their 60s and I just want them to stay at home as much as possible. And I would prefer for them to not have to go out. So obviously they need food, so we've been doing their food shopping. But she's gotta be difficult because she doesn't like Trader Joe's. So we're going to the food store now that my mom likes to do my parents' food shopping, and then we're gonna go drop it off to them. If you live in proximity, like close to your parents, I think it's a great thing to do right now if you have the time and the ability to do so. I just, you know, don't want my parents having to go out for anything unless they really have to. They luckily can both work from home, so they haven't had to leave the house or anything. So that's what we're on our way to do now. But honestly, they were following, I think, a good thing at Trader Joe's because they had us wait outside to get in. There wasn't a lot of people in the store, so it definitely made it good and it was fully stocked and stuff. Like the past couple weeks when we had been going, there really wasn't much fresh meat or fresh produce or anything, but it was basically fully stocked. They didn't have our carne asada, which we loved to buy there. That's like Steven's favorite, and they have not had it since any of this has happened. I feel like it's like a top seller. But everything else we were able to get, so I'm happy about that. I'll show you guys what we get at Trader Joe's once we get home. All right, into grocery store number two we go. Also, comment down below, do you guys call it a grocery store or do you call it a food store? I've always called it a food store, but when I say that in vlogs, people are like, why are you calling it that? It's a grocery store. So I started to call it grocery store now. So comment down below what you call it, food store or grocery store?
Food store.
Yeah, you say, he says food store too. I think it's like a New Jersey thing, I don't know. Steven's gonna go disinfect the little basket there. We bring disinfectant wipes with us and hand sanitizer and all that, and try our best not to touch really anything that we don't need to touch in the food store or grocery store. Taking our precautions. This is what the paper goods aisle looks like in this store. Oh my god. All right, you guys, successful second trip. It was honestly pretty terrifying because in there, almost everyone I feel like had masks and gloves on. It's just so weird. Like, I understand why, of course. It's just so strange to see that now. Like, people are just out at the food store wearing this, like, big mask and gloves and everything. It's just,
that
like...
kind of feel like 6 feet away from people and it's crowded. It's kind of difficult.
Yeah, because there was, like, a lot more people in this food store than in Trader Joe's. And I don't know. Yeah, like, everyone just, like, they had markings on the floor to show where, like, 6 feet was. And, I mean, it's good, but it's just so weird. Like, the new normal, I guess. Ooh, my hair is looking crazy. It's raining out now to add on top of everything else, but we got all our stuff that we needed. I figured that I would share with you guys the little like system me and Steven have going on.
I guess you call that.
I mean, I don't know.
It falls at the protocol.
In my head, I think it works and it's like the safest bet. Cause my biggest fear is like when you're in the food store and stuff, you're touching everything, then you're touching your phone and maybe on accident you touch your face, like whatever. Obviously you want to touch as little stuff as possible. So basically the system that we use when we go into the food stores, I hold everything.
I'm
so
the sacrificial lamb. I'm the one who has to touch all the stuff.
Well, I said to Steven, like one of us should be the one that touches the cart and touches the food to put it in the cart and everything, and the other one should have everything else. So basically I hold the phone because I write like our grocery list on my phone, so we need that because that's how I like remember what we need. So I have my phone so I can look at the grocery list. I hold this like the keys for Steven's car, Steven's wallet, his credit card, everything like that we need, you know, money we need to pay for the food, whatever, so that I'm only touching, I don't touch anything like at the food store, none of the food. So Steven like will go through, I'll say like, okay, we need this and this. Steven will touch it and put it into the cart, but then he's not touching anything like his wallet or his keys or anything else.
Or his phone or anything like that.
Right, or his phone, so that nothing gets like cross-contaminated. So he knows like he has stuff in his hand, so he doesn't touch anything besides the cart and the food.
Like, she'll, when we get back to the truck, she'll open the door. Like,
yes.
She'll take my keys out of my pocket, she'll unlock it.
Like, I open all the doors so that nothing is getting, I mean, at least in my mind, it makes me feel better. Who knows if it's actually working?
I touch all the food in my hand, so the stuff's still on the food.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I don't know, it helps a little bit.
Yeah, so that's just what we've been doing. I don't know. I feel, it makes me feel a little bit better, like, hopefully, like, because then I know, and then I'll, we have this little spray, like, hand sanitizer that we use. Obviously, when we get home, we fully wash, but we use the hand sanitizer, so then when we get in the truck, I spray the hand sanitizer in his hands and in my hands, and then hopefully, I mean, we're doing as best as we can. So that's a little system we've been using.
If I violate a protocol, like, all hell breaks loose.
We were at Trader Joe's and he went to grab for his wallet and I was like, no, let me get it. Cause like, you know, I don't know, like we disinfect everything anyways when we get home. Like we disinfect our phones and his wallet and the credit card and stuff anyways. But like, I just would rather me touch it instead of him, who he's just touched everything in the food store. You know what I mean? Just as an extra layer.
Yeah. It works, I think. It's better than nothing.
Yeah, I think it's better than nothing. It might just all be in my head, but I figured that I'd share with you guys like what we've been doing. All right, we just got back from dropping the food off at my parents' house. Now we're finally back at our house. It's like a whole big process because we live like 30 minutes from my parents. But I have our bags from Trader Joe's and I'm gonna go through and show you guys what we got. We didn't get a ton of stuff. They were out of some things, but they were pretty well stocked, I would say. So first thing, unsweetened vanilla almond milk. I love this. I use this in like a whole bunch of stuff. Put it in coffee. I make like chia seed pudding with it. I don't think I've ever actually drank almond milk on its own, but it'd probably be good. I don't know, but I always buy this at Trader Joe's. So we got that. I got two of these. Oh my gosh. This is like the best snack option. If you like pistachios, y'all are gonna love these. These are the pistachio cranberry bites. They're like these little bites here. They're not that big. They're like little, maybe this big, like little bar kind of things. And it's pistachios, dried cranberries, and agave syrup. They are delicious. They're so good. So I'm like obsessed. There's not that many that come in these bags though. Yeah, there's only six of them. And like I said, they're not that big. So they're a great little snack option. They are pre-individually like portioned. But since I don't get too many of them, I got two bags because they had them and I like them. We have Steven's snack that he already ate almost all of. Is there even anything left in here? Oh, there's like one little thing left in here. This is the Trader Joe's natural turkey jerky, just the original. You didn't really like this, like you said.
They're like sweet. They're a little too sweet for me.
I don't know. He ate almost all of them, so they can't be that bad. We got this enchilada sauce. I don't know. We both like eyed this and then
I saw it. We walked past it. I was like, it looks good. Kelly says something, we'll get it. And of course she said something. So I was like, yep, I was looking at it too. So we got it.
Well, we walked by it and I was, cause we love enchiladas. So I was like, okay, we've never tried it. I don't know. The calories aren't very bad, like on it at all. Some of these can be very, very high in like sugar and calories and stuff. This one isn't too bad. No added sugars. There's actually zero sugar in it at all and only 30 calories. So I was like, all right, let's try it. You know, to add to like boneless chicken breast or something. I figured it'd be good. We picked up one of these breaded chicken breast tenderloins. Never tried these before, but I figured maybe in like a salad or something they would be good. They're breaded. We always have grilled chicken in our freezer. So we have a bunch of like grilled chicken breasts, but I figured maybe for a little change, some breaded chicken. We got that. We got my cauliflower gnocchi, which I love. Steven hates this, but I love it. So I get the cauliflower gnocchi. I think it's delicious. Honestly, I like it better than regular gnocchi because I feel like regular gnocchi has no taste to it. The cauliflower gnocchi has like a lot of taste to it and it's very good. So I got that and then I got regular gnocchi for Steven. This is the gnocchi a la Sorrentina. So it has tomato sauce and mozzarella cheese and it's like regular gnocchi, not cauliflower. So this is for Steven. And then also we got their french fries. These are pretty good. If you like them, we cook them in the air fryer. They're really good. I'm like handing them to Steven. He's putting them in the freezer behind you guys. And then Steven got these. We've never tried these before. This is chicken chili verde burritos.
They look good. I hope not too spicy, but
so. Yeah, they look good. So that's everything in the first bag. Then we got like more of the fresh produce in this bag. So this, again, I love this for like lunches and stuff. This is a grilled balsamic rosemary chicken. So it's basically just grilled chicken with balsamic and rosemary. It's already cooked and everything. It's delicious. I add this to salads on top of like a little pita bread or something for lunch. It's very, very good. So I always normally buy this every week. Then we got some organic, these are blackberries. I normally buy blackberries and strawberries. They didn't have any strawberries this week, which stunk. So just blackberries this week. So we got a bigger thing of that because I couldn't get my strawberries. We got some bell peppers. So I use peppers and like onions and stuff and like everything. So we of course got that. Oh, I think something is leaking. Ah! Yes, okay. So we need to clean that.
Woo! This one exploded.
Look at it. Oh. Yeah, one of the peppers like exploded and now there's like stuff everywhere. All right, we got that cleaned up. One of the peppers like exploded, but back to our scheduled processing. I picked these up for the first time today. These are the shaved Brussels sprouts. I normally buy Brussels sprouts there. Steven hates them.
They stink.
Okay, all right, but I like Brussels sprouts. I only make them for myself, so I'm gonna try the shaved ones and like see if I do those with like a little garlic, salt and pepper, a little oil, like kind of saute them up. I think they would be good, so I'm excited about that. We got this balsamic rosemary beef steak tips. They didn't have a ton of fresh meat today, so we picked this up. Like I said, we always have chicken at home. We eat a lot of chicken, but like we wanted to change it up a little bit. So I got this. Hopefully it's good. I don't know. We never tried it. I got some of this wine country chicken salad. So I don't know. I thought this looked good. It says it has cranberries and pecans. I like chicken salad. So I thought maybe on like a little pita or something for lunch or with some crackers, it would be a good little lunch thing. So I got that. Steven got this. What is this? Like pastrami lunch meat? I did not know that we got this. I don't like pastrami, but Steven does. So I guess for lunch or whatever. This is, of course, definitely a Steven pick. He loves this. So he's getting like assorted meats, but the Italian meats are so good. Assorted meats. What? Why are you laughing?
Assorted meats.
That is what it is. So I don't know. This is chorizo, jamón, which is dried ham, I guess. And then salami?
Yeah.
A little assortment there for you.
That's prosciutto.
Oh yeah, that's good. We like that. And then last but certainly not least, we just got the shaved beefsteak again. Since we already have chicken and stuff at home, wanted to get something a little different. We like this for like salads. If you do like a steak salad, this is really, really good. Because it's like very thinly sliced steak. So we get that at Trader Joe's and it's really good. So that is everything that we got at Trader Joe's. That's our little haul of stuff. We got a lot of stuff that we have like in our freezer and stuff, so we didn't need to do like a full grocery shopping, but that's more than enough to get us through the week. And yeah. Hi guys, so it is the next day. I'm getting ready to leave right now. I think I need to put a jacket on though, because I put on a short sleeve shirt thinking that it was warm outside, but I think it's actually cold out. It's so sad because I used to always be that girl that always knew the weather forecast. Like I always would look it up. I would always know what the weather was supposed to be like the next day. Oh my God, I don't even know what the weather is like because I don't look anymore. Because I mean, we don't leave our house, so what's the point of caring what the weather's like, which is so sad. I just literally realized that now. But anyways, that's life. Right now, so I am getting ready to leave the house though right now because I'm gonna go drop off a big box of makeup at one of my friend's house, which might seem super stupid to you guys right now, but let me explain. So one of my best friends, I talked about this I think in another video, but she is an ER nurse at our local hospital here that is getting hit very, very, very hard with the virus. So I was basically thinking about like what I could do to help because I know a lot of the local restaurants in our area have been donating like tons of food and stuff to the nurses for them to have like nice food to eat while they're working. Some people have been like sewing masks and stuff and donating them. I can't sew, and Lord knows nobody in that ER wants to eat any food that I make. Not the best cook. So I was thinking, you know, I was like, you know what if I donated a big box of new makeup and like brought it over to you, and then you could bring it into work, and then like maybe everybody could like take something and like get some new makeup to play with. Like playing with makeup always makes me feel better, and I thought maybe at least a little bit it could brighten somebody's day, like if they got some new makeup to play with. So I got together a big box of new stuff, and she was like, yeah, that would be so amazing, like I think people would really like that, because obviously I know there are like so much more serious things that they need right now, but I can't provide them with, you know, masks and stuff like that. Like I don't have any way to like get that. Like me and Steven don't even have masks like when we go out or anything. We don't wear them or anything because I don't want to buy them because I know the healthcare workers need them. But so I just wanted to do something, at least a little something. So it's actually so sad because she literally is working with this every single day at work. I can't even actually see her. Like I'm going to go and put the box in the parking lot of like her apartment complex where she lives, and then she'll come out once we leave to like get it, because she is like, you know, exposed to it obviously at work, which is just so sad. Like I miss her. And yeah, but I'm gonna go drop that off at her apartment, so there will be no social contact or anything, but we're gonna go do that right now. And hopefully it will make at least somebody happy, because I know the nurses, and not even just the nurses, everybody at the hospitals, everybody, I mean, literally anyone involved in an essential business is working so hard right now, like to keep our world going. And I'm just so thankful. And this is just a very small way of me hopefully being able to show some appreciation. So that's what we're gonna do. That's like the big to-do of today, to leave the house. So I did my makeup, got all glam, because I'm like, okay, well, I mean, I'm not gonna see anybody, but I'm gonna leave the house. So let's do something. So that's what we're gonna go do. All right, so I got this big box that we had from when we moved, actually. I wrote a little letter because my friend who works there told me to write a little note, like explaining so people knew where all this makeup was coming from. But yeah, I just filled this box up with a bunch of new stuff. I did like all palettes and stuff back over here so people that like eyeshadow could get stuff. And then I have like different foundations, lippy products, brow products, primers, like everything in here. So hopefully everyone can get something. She said there's over 100 people that work with her. So I wanted to make sure I had enough for at least everybody in the ER department. And then I'm sure in the hospital, there's like way more than that. So try to think of like people that don't really like makeup and stuff, like more skincare products and then more makeup. So everyone can get a little something to hopefully brighten their day. So I'm going to go drop this off now. Steven's kind enough to carry the box out. I'll get the door for you because it's a little heavy. Thank you, babe. Stop. It's not that heavy. I tried to not overload it so that she would be able to carry it.
We're good.
Good to go. All right, mission complete. We just dropped it off. I think everyone was like, what are these people doing? Because yeah. It's kind of like sus because there's people everywhere walking around here and like we're just putting this big box like on the sidewalk. So I called my friend and was like, okay, we were going to drive away. So can you come out and get it? Because I feel like people might call the police or something. Like, what is this suspicious package?
Yeah,
like
just dropping off on the sidewalk.
Just dropping off on the sidewalk and then leaving. So she just came out and got it. So we're all good.
Yeah, I think the people kind of figured out what was going on after.
Yeah, because we were kind of just sitting in the car and there was people kind of looking at us and we were like, but I'm glad that we dropped that off. So yeah, I think we're going to end the vlog here. I hope that you guys enjoyed this little vlog and we'll be back soon with more vlogs. Bye.